In this tutorial, we will see a simple and easy to use basic technique on how to use the Path Tool. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the video description. We will start by making the Path Tool active. This can be done by going to Tools and then click on Paths. Or you can just click on the Paths icon in the toolbox. The shortcut for this tool is the B key. The Edit Mode Design should be checked. Zoom into the object by holding the Control key and rolling the mouse wheel away from you. Just click the first node or control point, then the next one, then the next one, and so on. Hold the spacebar down and move the mouse to move the image. We will edit the straight lines later on. With Ctrl Z we can undo one or more previous steps, and with Ctrl Y we can redo them again. In this way we go around our subject. When we are close to the first node, we hover the mouse pointer over it. Press and hold the Control key, and when the chain icon is visible, we can click to close the path. By clicking and dragging a node, we can still make corrections. Zoom out or press Ctrl+Shift+J to maximize the image in the window. Now we check the option Edit. Zoom in again. Click and drag a node on one of the lines to make a curve like so. When we let go of the mouse, we cannot move this node anymore, but we can undo it with Ctrl Z. When the node is made, we can make corrections with the handles. In this simple way, we can make our curves in the path. When all this is to our liking, we can click on the button Selection from Path to make the selection. Then we click on a random tool in the toolbox to make the path invisible. Or we press the B key, and this also makes the path invisible but leaves the Path Tool active. And that's how we can, in a simple and easy way, make very accurate selections with the Path Tool. In the video description, there is a link to an in-depth article on the GIMP website about the Path Tool. I hope this tutorial helps, and if that's the case, please give it a thumbs up. And a nice comment is of course much appreciated. Thanks for watching.